So this is day two of the video blog, and I just wanted to actually go back a step because I realised that a lot of people who are watching this didn't know the full extent of what happened. So I'm going to go over that briefly. But basically, I was snowboarding with a friend of mine in Chatel, and there was a bit of fresh snow on the ground. It wasn't a huge powder day, but we got a bit overexcited, and then the clouds came in, and it was like a complete whiteout. You couldn't see. You couldn't tell the snow from the cloud. You couldn't tell if you were going up or down, and I thought I was somewhere else, but obviously I didn't have any point of reference. Anyway, long story short, I fell off a cliff. I fell off a cliff about 20 meters onto some. Well, actually, luckily I didn't fall directly onto the rocks. I bounced off some snow onto some rocks. I broke my T10. Damaged my spinal cord. I'm paralyzed from the waist down, and I also dislocated my hip and broke a rib. So yeah, it was a fairly big knock, and to be honest, if you had seen my helmet, it was smashed to pieces, man. Like, so what can I say? Always wear a helmet, don't be a dick, especially if you're snowboarding near cliffs in a whiteout. But anyway, I don't want to preach, you know, do what you want to do, but like, that saved my life, and that's why I'm here. Anyway, so moving on, because I really want to try and keep these quite brief. I waffled on my first one. I had some more physio this morning, and it was brilliant. I really like Fabrice. He's such a cool physio. I've got a little bit of sad news, good news and sad news. I was going to go to Evian on the 28th, but now I'm going to go to tomorrow. So unfortunately today was my last day with Fabrice, and he's such a cool guy, but we did lots of things. So we were like wheeling around in the wheelchair, and so there's lots of things that you never think about, like, oh yeah, life in a wheelchair, I'll just wheel around. But like, what if you need to go through a door? And I was like, oh yeah. So he's like, okay, how are you going to get through this door? And I was like, I tried it a few times. It's like puzzle solving, you know. It was really quite interesting. So he taught me how to get through doors, and then he's like, what about this door? Because there's a step, you know, like it's an outside door, there's a step. And I don't know. And he said, like, the best way to go through this door is backwards. So, and it's difficult, like I say, like anything's difficult. Like when you're a kid, learning to walk is difficult, but you practice it every day and you don't realize it. So all these things are going to get a lot easier. So yeah, you open the door, you kind of turn the wheelchair around, you go backwards down the step. You got to be really careful actually, because I almost fell out the back, but luckily they put that thing on to stop me wheeling. I don't know if I told that story, but it was really funny. I'll quickly go over it. But when they first put me in the wheelchair, because I used to have a friend with a wheelchair and he used to let me have a go in it, and I used to practice wheeling and I used to balance on two wheels like quite well. So I'd already had that sort of skill, but they had no idea. So as soon as I got in the wheelchair, I pulled a wheelie and all four of them shit themselves. They were like, ah! Like leapt on me, put me on the floor, and now they've got this like little leg thing that they've put on the back of my wheelchair, which stops me wheeling. And that's that was lucky actually, because when I went outside the door, oh, hi. Sorry, I'm just making a little video for my family. Okay, let's just carry on. Okay. So yeah, they put this little thing on the back to stop me from wheeling, which is good, because when I went out this door backwards down the step, I would have definitely fallen backwards because the whole chair went like that. So that was quite cool. But yeah, so yeah, what can I say? I'm going to miss Fabrice. He's a really cool guy. I'm going to miss everyone here. The hospital here at Annecy is amazing. All the staff have been super nice. It's super clean. It's super beautiful. Like, it's snowing outside right now. It looks amazing. And I'm going to Evian tomorrow for rehabilitation. So it's going to be a new adventure, and I'm very, very, very excited about it. So yeah, got a little bit distracted there. The cleaning lady came in. And anyway. So we did some more exercises today, which was really good. It's so crazy about like how much stronger you get. Like, I, I felt like the exercises I was doing yesterday were so hard, and then when I did them today, they were so much easier. They're still really hard, but they're so much easier, and I can't believe it. It's like it's crazy how, I don't know, your body, I don't know. I mean, the human body is fucking incredible. When I was saying goodbye to the nurses and I was saying goodbye to Fabrice, like I say, I said, oh shit, man, this is going to be the last time I see you. And he was like, yeah, and I shook his hand and I just said, I just really want to say that I really enjoyed meeting you. You're a really, really cool guy. I really like you. And I was really upset. So, and as bizarre as it sounds, like, I'm actually upset to leave because everyone here is so nice. One of the other really bizarre things about the whole experience is that my time here in hospital, even though, like, losing my legs and stuff, it's been one of the happiest times of my life. It's been one of the coolest, like, it's been, you know, obviously it's been one of the fucking darkest times of my life when I didn't want to live without legs. I mentioned that in the previous one, but it's also been, like I say, like, I'm sad to leave. I'm excited to leave, but like, I don't know, I get to know all the nurses and the doctors, and they all seem to be like quite like me. I mean, like, they're sort of quite warm to me, and they appreciate, because of that I'm English, that I speak a little bit of French, because a lot of English people don't. And they just, I don't know, I'm just gonna miss all of them. Oh, anyway, so I've got another funny story, which is quite good. I'm going to share something personal with you guys now. From the last video blog, it can't be get more personal than that, right? I shit myself. But as some of you know, I'm a little bit incontinent. I hope to regain this sooner rather than later. And apparently it can be achieved. But I have a thing called the sondage, which is it's a tube that I put down, or that goes in my willy. So it goes down my urethra, quite a long way actually, like it goes in quite a long way. And if you ever try putting something in your urethra, it's not that I have or anything, but like, it's pretty painful, but luckily I don't feel that much down there. And it's for weeing basically. So it's like, you know, every 6 hours they come in and they fill up a bag of piss. But they're teaching me to do that myself, which is cool. So I'm going to have to do that. They were going to do that today, but unfortunately, for some bizarre reason, they didn't do it. But also, this is quite a funny story. I also have what's called a suppositoire. In English, it's a suppository. Something that you put up your ass. And it helps you, because I'm quite constipated most of the time, and I think it's from the morphine, and it's quite common, especially, well, because of the lack of movement. My bowels do move, I do shit, obviously, from the first blog, you'll know that. Anyway, I'm talking too much, but anyway, the point is, they said, look, you've got to learn to do the suppository yourself. So today, I did that myself, which was quite funny. And so they get this little thing out, and it looks like a bullet from a fairly sort of like low caliber gun. Obviously, I don't want it to be like a high caliber rifle, fucking hell. Well, you know, it's not my cup of tea, but you know, each to their own. But anyway, and he said, yeah, you've got to put this in your bum yourself. And I was like, oh, okay, cool, sweet. Can I get like a rubber glove? And he was like, you know what, like, at first, I want you to do it without the rubber glove. I was like, really? Oh, that sounds weird, man. Like, okay. He's like, just because I want you to feel where it is. And I was like, I'm pretty sure I could feel where it is with a rubber glove. But anyway, so I put this thing in my bum. And when they do it, it's kind of like, yeah, they roll you over, and they're like, it's time for the suppositoire. And you're like, okay, cool. And then it's like, goes in, you're like, you can feel it a little bit. When I put it in, it was fucking painful, man. I was just like ramming it in there. I was like, get in there. Like, why is it so much resistance? And then all of a sudden it's like, whoosh. I was like, oh, fucking hell. I was like, don't know why I said it in a Bolton accent, but yeah, I was like, fucking hell, I just put something big right in my bum. I've never done that before. It's really funny. I mean, one time I did put my finger in my bum in the shower. I don't know why I said that. Fuck's sake, man. This morphine really makes, it's like a weird drunken truth serum. Anyway, obviously that's a common medical procedure, but if you're unaware of it, and then you get told that you've got to do that, like, until you get the feeling in your willy back, then that's, you know, that's yeah, it's a kind of a weird thing to get used to, grips with. Anyway, I'm not sure if I've got that much more to share. I've shared enough already. I tell you, this blog, man, the morphine as well just really does make me just blurt nonsense out. But hopefully you guys are entertained by it and not just like, what the fuck is this guy talking about? Yeah, I just wanted to add one more thing. When I said yesterday about the machine that I got to stand up in and put my feet on, I've got a video of it and I'll show you. I remember when I said I took like but one hand off and then two hands off and then like managed for like almost 3 seconds to like balance with two hands off. Well, I managed a little bit more progress today and I made a video especially about that for you. So I'll include that. I'll include that now.
Making a lot of progress today. Are you ready? That's the one hand. And that's the other hand. And
I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly.